Hello, I'm Yash Tegele, a student at Edinburgh High School, and my research focuses on harvesting wind energy from high altitudes.
Today, various renewable systems have been heavily researched. Among these, wind energy stands out, as it can be harvested 24/7 and nearly all year round. Wind has the potential to power the planet 100 times over, yet only 5% of Earth's power comes from the wind. It's primarily because wind is slowest near the Earth's crust, and ground wind turbines alter the landscape, affecting the local biosphere. Harvesting wind energy can be nearly continuous and a lot more efficient if we could operate the wind farms airborne, as wind power increases dramatically with increasing altitude. This concept alone has the potential to revolutionize how we harvest energy. This motivated researchers to think about airborne wind energy system termed AWS, which started gaining traction in the last decade. They aim to harness the power of high altitude winds and have the potential to produce energy at a significantly lower cost than traditional wind turbines while having a smaller environmental impact. Studies have shown that tethered array can consume up to 80% of the available power in AWS, greatly reducing its efficiency. Current AWS fail to operate at high altitude as tethered array increases faster at a quintic rate, whereas wind power increases at a cubic rate with increasing altitude. Tether's slender profile also renders a threat to the local bird life. Currently, the concept of combating tether drag in AWS system primarily involves the use of multiple kites that share a tether, or a system utilizing three tethers that connect at a central point. These figures point out these concepts. However, it should be noted that these concepts are still in their theoretical stage and have yet to be prototyped and tested. Furthermore, it is important to note that these systems may still be prone to the same problems, such as limited operational altitude and high tether drag losses. In my research, I set out to design a novel tether-free AWS system comprised of a vertical airborne wind turbine energy farm that aims to tap into the energy from high-altitude winds without the use of a tether. The primary motivation behind this design is twofold. Firstly, overcome the limitations imposed by tether drag, and secondly, optimize the design to enable a scalable, sustainable, and high-power clean energy source that can be utilized even in remote areas. My proposed VAWT energy farm utilizes several novel, highly efficient, lightweight vertical wind turbine trimmed energy cells attached to a custom-built streamlined helium balloon. This design allows the system to operate at high altitudes, where wind is the most potent, accessing previously unattainable wind energy. Each vertical wind turbine unit, termed an energy cell, utilizes an innovative approach to harnessing wind energy through the implementation of a 5-blade modified version of a Darrius-type wind turbine. The energy cell is comprised of three major parts: the blades, guide vanes, and the flying electric generator. The blade is twisted at nearly 12 degrees and can produce enough lift at varying wind conditions to support 60 to 90% of the weight of the entire system. Guide vanes are designed to direct the flow of air in specific directions, thereby increasing the wind velocity of the system. By creating a vortex within the energy cell, the guide vanes aid in boosting the power output of the system. Altitude control is a critical component for reliable operation. To gain elevation, the generators in the system function as motors and produce lift. Once the desired altitude is reached and the wind velocities increase, the blades of the turbine begin to rotate, and this transition marks the beginning of the energy harvesting phase. This two-step approach is quite common in the field. The arrangement of the energy cells on a grid on a farm bed is crucial to increase the efficiency of the system. The farm also incorporates crossflow fans and central hub. A key aspect of this energy farm design is the ability to maintain stable operation and generate power effectively. To avoid drift, crossflow fans are utilized in my design. These fans consume auxiliary power to keep the system in one place. The central hub is designed to house computer and other necessary electronics capable of controlling the location and altitude of the energy farm based on various onboard and radar-based weather data. There are numerous challenges associated with designing and implementing a completely airborne tether-free energy system. To address these, a variety of strategies discussed ahead have been employed. Angular rotation, even though poses little threat to the durability of the system, is still critical to avoid for ease of control and effective energy management. Contra-rotating energy cells, wherein half the turbine spin in opposite direction and a streamlined farm shape which passively corrects for unwanted rotation, are utilized in my design. The outer part of energy cell is made of fine and high modulus carbon fiber meshing, while the inner part comprises of hydrophobic fabric, which helps to prevent water damage from clouds and rain. The 40-60 carbon fiber to fabric composite offers durability while being light in weight. Wind turbulence may seem like a big issue, however, the wind velocities are very consistent, about 20,000 feet, and the turbulent land scale is relatively high, reducing the severity of wind turbulence. To verify the feasibility of my design, I conducted a range of analyses including numerical analysis and computational fluid dynamic simulation using Fluence on supercomputer. In addition, real-world testing of the prototype was conducted through Schlieren imaging, simulating a wind tunnel test, and stress testing. These tests provided valuable data on the performance and durability of the system. By combining numerical analysis, safety simulations, and experimental analysis, I was able to verify my work to achieve a technology readiness level of 3, demonstrating the potential of my tether-free airborne wind energy system. In the interest of delivering a comprehensive and succinct presentation, I will provide a high-level summary of the numerical analysis results. I have included the full derivation and equations in the slides, which are available for your review. During the analysis, I performed calculations for two distinct operational locations to assess the feasibility and efficiency of the proposed system. For an even more comprehensive analysis, please refer to the research paper I wrote below. The power factor is a metric I created to rate the efficiency of different designs. The graph displays the total number of devices against the power factor. Whenever the power factor surpasses zero, the system is successfully generating power. The current design has an x-intercept 11 energy cells, which is quite good, indicating the efficiency and positive net power production. This metric has proven useful in comparing different designs, and this design has shown a significant improvement compared to others. Through extensive numerical analysis, I have optimized the design of the airborne wind energy system, leveraging the use of streamlined balloon guide vanes, twisted blades, and a helium balloon to maximize the power output. It can be concluded that this design has true megawatt level power potential when scaled. Now, let's transition to computational fluid dynamics, or CFD, which is a useful tool for simulating real-world scenarios with high accuracy using finite element method. In my simulation, I was able to utilize state-of-the-art computing technologies through Minnesota Supercomputer Institute on their Mesabi supercomputing cluster. The Fluent Package 6.1 enhances fluids is utilized for high accuracy and its robust set of features. I was able to accurately model the behavior of my design in a variety of real-world scenarios, which helped me optimize the design for maximum energy output and structural integrity. The Fluent K Epsilon turbulence model was utilized. Fine meshing was used throughout all the tests to assure accurate results. The analysis was performed using transient timing methods. The system was also monitored for unwanted rotations along z-axis through the implementation of a 6 degrees of freedom z-axis rotation method. In order to optimize the drag coefficient, which is a measure of the aerodynamic resistance of an object in motion, I tested multiple design iterations. Of the designs that I explored, two notable ones, named after famous mathematicians, are reported here. The Archimedes design featured two balloons, which ensured balance and removed any concerns of toppling. However, the total drag of this design was 0.6, which is way too high. The second design, Euler, featured a streamlined fish-like body shape with a total drag of only 0.18, making it much suitable for operation. This design offered numerous advantages, such as minimizing angular momentum by passively correcting for it, spreading the air more equally amongst all the wind turbines, always facing the wind head-on, allowing for smooth travel, and more. Through numerous design iterations, I was able to achieve Euler, a design that optimizes for power generation and functionality. I calculated the total power produced by one energy cell using a tip speed ratio, or TSR, of 4 in Fluent. The blades were rotated at 471 radians per second, and the total power produced was calculated to be 1.5 kilowatts. I was delighted to find that this matched perfectly with my expectations of power. Furthermore, the calculated coefficient of power for this system was 0.409, which is a measure of the total power available to the harvested power. The detailed mesh size of the fan and the flow trajectories on the fan are depicted in the figure, while the graph illustrates the power captured by a single energy cell in the first 5 minutes of operation. These results are truly encouraging and demonstrate the promising potential of this design for producing clean and sustainable energy. To optimize the guide vanes in my design, I treated the entire guide vane as a stationary wall, just as it would be in the upper atmosphere. Through the simulation, it was found that the guide vanes generated a vortex and increased the stability by directing the airflow. Multiple combinations of guide vanes were tested, and it was found that the highest torque was achieved with 4 guide vanes. The data and the different runs were summarized in the table, and it can clearly be seen that 4 guide vanes produces the maximum torque. In conclusion, the CFD analysis proved to be an essential tool in accurately simulating the wind turbine's performance. With its help, I was able to measure drag, calculate the power production, and optimize the guide vanes for improved stability. The CFD results were utilized in numerical analysis to ensure an accurate model. These findings have laid the foundation for experimental analysis, where I will test and validate the results from both CFD and numerical analysis. I designed, built, and tested multiple prototypes using various methods to fine-tune the design for optimal power production. I conducted stress tests to assess the structural integrity of the design, as well as Schlieren imaging to visualize the flow of air around the wind turbine blades. I also built a homemade simulated wind tunnel test. In the initial stress testing for the first prototype, it became apparent that the design was structurally weak and at high RPMs it would deform easily. To overcome this problem, I added 3 linear reinforcement plates to the design to increase its structural integrity. This modification greatly improved the stability of the structure, and it conducted several drop tests on both designs to determine their durability. Throughout the testing phase, I developed and tested several wind turbine prototypes that have been named after famous scientists, Euclid, Gauss, Pythagoras, and Turing. Euclid was created out of foam board to demonstrate a functional moving prototype, while Pythagoras was constructed with superior structural integrity and incorporated space for fans and central hubs within. Gauss, on the other hand, introduced guide vanes, space for battery, and crosswell fans to the mix. While Turing was simply a larger version of Gauss, with help from statists, I was able to produce the Turing prototype, and my ultimate goal is to fly this model in the air. These prototypes were crucial in ensuring that the model functions correctly, and were also used to double-check the elements that might have been overlooked in the CAD renderings. Over time, each prototype improved significantly, with Turing being the most successful design. These videos demonstrate the making and operation of Gauss prototype. Schlieren imaging is a technique used to visualize changes in the refractive index of a medium due to variations in the density. This technique can be used to visualize air flows and temperature gradients, making it a useful tool for analyzing fluid dynamics. In my experiment, I use Schlieren to test different wind shapes and analyze their flow patterns. In the first test, I compared the Darrius and Sylvanius wind turbines to see if there is a difference in the tip speed ratio. The results show that Darrius turbine is better designed with a higher RPM than the Sylvanius turbine, as expected. In the second test, I tested two Darrius turbines of different heights to see if making a turbine taller aids in faster RPM. The results showed that the RPM stays the same, making the height to power a bilinear relationship. These tests also revealed the vortices created by the wings, and we can see that the airfall does not have a huge impact on its surrounding, making it even more ideal. In conclusion, my analysis has led me to independently reach a TRL level of 3 by designing, building, and testing numerous prototypes, implementing key features, addressing challenges, and devising mitigation strategies. I use state-of-the-art computational tools and Schlieren testing to validate my results, ensuring the highest level of accuracy. This design has the potential to revolutionize the way we harvest energy and usher in a new era of renewable power generation. With further research and development of this technology can be optimized for cost, making it a viable alternative to traditional energy sources. I'm excited about the possibilities and optimistic about the future of this project. In the future, I plan to test the Turing model in a wind tunnel and eventually in the sky. Additionally, I will explore the potential of microwave beaming and Bladbergh-like devices to minimize auxiliary power. Overall, I'm proud to say that I designed and built all the parts of this project, and my efforts have resulted in a successful wind turbine system design. As we move forward, I hope to continue to work on this project, and maybe even one day, we can see my design soaring high in the sky, generating clean energy for all the world.